Yes, welcome back students. Once again we are going to continue with our subject digital communication. We are going to start with our second unit. The second unit covers the waveform coding techniques and its representation. So this unit is going to get divided into two parts. The first three are going to be few modulation techniques followed by the coding techniques. So the modulation technique which we are going to discuss in our second unit is differential pulse code modulation, delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation scheme and adaptive differential pulse code modulation techniques. Apart from that, we are going to see the line coding techniques and its power spectral density for different coding techniques such as unipolar, polar, return to zero, non-return to zero, bipolar, non-return to zero and Manchester coding techniques. And for today's topic, we are going to see the first modulation technique, that is differential pulse code modulation technique, its transmitter, the receiver part of it and the analysis of it. The rest of the topics is going to be discussed in the next video. To start with, before going what is differential pulse code modulation technique, we will see what is a basic pulse code modulation technique, what are its components and why we specifically go for DPCM. So the basic components of your digital modulation scheme is you are going to have a transmitter section, a receiver section, of course a channel or a medium over which the data is going to get transmitted. So in the transmission section, you are going to have an analog signal. That analog signal is going to convert it into a binary sequence, that is a digital form, where if you are going to make use of the components such as sampler, quantizer and encoder, the output is going to be a pulse code modulated signal. So before going to the sampling part of it, you are going to make use of a low pass filter, where this low pass filter is going to prevent the aliasing problem. All these things were already discussed in your previous semester while you studied your analog communication. So here you are going to have your analog message. This analog message is going to be converted into a binary sequence of digital. So PCM is nothing but analog to digital converter, where it comprises of a sampling circuit, quantizing and encoding part. Of course, the sampling is going to be done with the help of your Nyquist rate, which was discussed in your first unit. And coming to the receiver part is going to be the regeneration of your impaired signal, which is original signal. For that, we are going to have your regenerator circuit. You do the reverse process, that is your decoding first, then a reconstruction filter, and you are going to have your original signal reconstructed. So this is your normal PCM. So you can see how it is depicted in the form of wave. So PCM is one of the modulation technique. It's a digital modulation technique. Here you are going to have analog information converted into binary sequence, that is in the form of ones and zeros. So you can have an analog signal. Here a sinusoidal signal is taken with the help of a carrier train of pulses, or a binary sequence of pulses. You can convert the sinusoidal signal with the help of your sampling period. The period is set as TS, or sampling frequency. You will be having your PCM output. This was well explained during your analog communication paper itself. Why we have to go for DPCM? Why not PCM? Here there is an issue. So what is the issue? So why we need DPCM is, when you are going to have samples which are highly correlated, it will result in some redundant information. So to overcome this redundant information, we are going to choose a new process where you are going to have the prediction done. With the help of it, you are going to decide what to do. So you are going to have the predicted sample values, where this predicted sample values are nothing but the previous outputs, and you are going to summarize them with the help of the quantized value. So such a process is called as differential PCM, or in short DPCM technique. So what is DPCM is, in your normal pulse code modulation technique, we are going to predict the previous samples with the help of the current sample and find what is the difference between your current one and the previous one, so that you can minimize the error which is going to occur, or you are going to set the quantization value such that you are going to minimize that error in such a way that the difference between your predicted value and the current sample is very, very minimum. So that is going to be your DPCM. Now we'll see what is a prediction filter. How we are going to do this? Only if you know what is a prediction filter, then we can construct a DPCM. So as I said, prediction is predict the present samples with the previous samples. So how we are going to predict it? Suppose if you want to transmit a data D, we are going to receive and you are going to add this with your previous pulse coded modulated sample. So when you find the difference between this, it will give you a predicted value that is going to be here considered as a prediction error, denoted as E of n. When this E of n is going to be very, very minimum, then we can say that the predicted value is almost similar to the previous sample, and you can have the even the highly correlated sample get transmitted. So this is going to be your prediction filter. This prediction filter comprises of a sampler and a predictor and a summation unit. So what you are going to do is, you are going to have the present sample, give it to the sampler circuit. The sampled output is passed on to the predictor. The predicted output is taken as x cap of t. The difference between the present sample and the previous predicted sample is taken as E of t. That is going to be your error sample, or it is called as a prediction error. So this is what is used in your DPCM, so that you can correct the quantization level, so that you can minimize the error and get a very good output. Now we will see what is your differential pulse code modulation, or DPCM. And this block represents your DPCM transmitter. So this DPCM transmitter is nothing but a combination of a quantizer circuit along with your predictor filter circuit with the summing circuits. So here your sampled input is xn of s, which is given to the summation circuit, whose input, another input, is going to be the predicted value, that is x cap of n of ts. This is going to lead to a difference signal, that is your predicted error signal E of nts, which is applied to the quantizer. So the quantized output is denoted as V of nts, and once again this quantized level is going to apply to another summation circuit, which is added with your predicted value, which results in your predicted input U of nts. So this output is going to be your quantized output, where the minimum amount of difference between the present and the previous values. So such a coded signal which is coming out with the help of the prediction filter is called as a differentially pulse coded modulated signal. So here the signal points are explained, where x of nts is the sampled input. So this is going to be your sampled input. X cap of nts is the predicted sample. So this is going to be your predicted sample. E of nts is going to be the difference of the sampled input and the predicted output. So this is going to be the predicted output, and this is going to be your sample input. The difference between this is going to be your prediction error. And V of nts, of course, is called as a quantized output. This U of nts is going to be the predictor's input, which is actually sum of the two signals. One is going to be the quantized input, another one is going to be the predictor output. So this output, which is coming out of this quantizer along with the predictor in the feedback path, is going to be your DPCM signal. So the predictor produces the assumed samples from the previous outputs of the transmitter circuit. The input to this predictor is a quantized version of the input signal X of NTS. So here, what is going to be the quantized output? The quantizer output is V of NTS, which is nothing but quantized value of your predicted error signal, error prediction, E of NTS. Or in other words, it is E of NTS plus Q of NTS, that is a quantization error. This is going to be the prediction error and this is going to be the quantization error. And the predictor input is going to be the sum of the quantizer output as well as the predictor output. So this is going to be your predictor input, U of NTS. What it is actually it is the sum of the two signals, that is the predicted output signal and the quantized output signal. So you are going to substitute the first equation in place of V of NTS. So you will be having X cap of NTS plus summation of your V of NTS, that is your quantizer output. Or in other words, this error is going to be very, very minimum. And if you are going to have the X cap of NTS, the summation of these two is nothing but your actual sampled input. So the same predictor circuit can be used in the decoder to reconstruct the original input. Next is, at the receiver side, how you are going to reconstruct your differentially pulse code modulated signal. So once again, you make use of the same predictor circuit. Here you are going to make use of a decoder unit, a predictor and a summing circuit, which constructs or which is going to form your DPCM receiver. So here the signal notations are represented as B of NTS, which is going to be the input signal to the decoder. V of NTS, the output of the decoder, is given to a summation circuit where it is V of NTS plus X cap of NTS, that is your predictor value, and this is your predicted output U of NTS. So here the notation of the signal which is used in the previous transmitter section is the same. So in the absence of the noise, the encoded receiver input will be the same as the encoded transmitter output. So here we are assuming that there is no noise. And the predictor assumes a value based on the previous outputs. The input given to the decoder is processed and that output is summed up with the output of the predictor to obtain the better output. So the output is going to be better because you are going to add up with the predicted signal. Thank you. And your next topic is going to be on delta modulation. We are going to see what is delta modulation and we are going to compare the PCM with the DPCM and we are going to see what are its applications as well as advantages. Thank you for today. Thank you.